Finally, U.S. Air Force tests Aurora SR-91 after upgrade. This plane doesn't exist. It doesn't have the ability to fly beyond Mach 6, nor fly at 135,000 feet, and isn't powered by an incredible pulse, wave detonation, engine tearing across our sky. After all, according to the US government, this plane isn't real, and this video is just a fantasy. But poring over countless dark websites, I've been able to piece together what this plane may be, why it likely exists, and how terrifying the skies above us really are. This is the top secret supposedly never built Aurora Black Triangle.
A hypersonic aircraft program. Ben Rich, former head of the Skunk Works, however, later revealed that this was actually the funding item for the development of the B-2 bomber, that it had nothing to do with an hypersonic airplane, and he has flatly said that such an airplane does not exist.
At the end of the SR-71 spy plane program in the 90s, the US was left without a new spy plane to operate across the world. The future SR-72 is still decades away, and for the last 30 years, supposedly the military has flown blind, or have they? There are many reports of strange triangle aircraft flying high above military air bases and across the world that seem to defy modern aviation physics, with abilities to fly faster than anything ever before and seemingly vanish into the clouds. Little is known about this plane, but it is estimated to fly at a top altitude of 135,000 feet and cruising at around 90,000 feet for operations. At these altitudes, the aircraft would have an incredible speed, easily pushing Mach 6 and tearing across the sky. To reach this pace, it would either have a ramjet or an early scramjet like the proposed SR-72, or it would have a very unique propulsion called the pulse wave detonation engine. Basically, this crazy idea uses small detonations of fuel to push the aircraft forwards constantly, chain reacting until the plane reaches the required speed. This will result in a very unique contrail of a ring of donuts, daisy chaining behind the aircraft, something that I'll get to in a moment. It is very different from normal engines that we have on aircraft today. You see all regular